It's not fair and it's not right.
Now to Las Vegas, where police say that Stephen Paddock, who shot dead 58 people on Sunday, may have been planning to escape instead of killing himself. They've not elaborated on what's led them to that conclusion, but they have suggested he had been living a secret life and had spent years building up his arsenal of weapons. Well, his girlfriend, Mary Lou Danley, is now being questioned by the FBI, but has said that she had no idea what he was planning. Our correspondent Laura Bicker reports now from Las Vegas.
Police believe Stephen Paddock had help getting hold of his arsenal of weapons. He legally bought some of his 47 guns here at a shop just outside Las Vegas. He owned dozens of semi-automatic weapons, which he modified to turn into machine guns. Officers are also trying to work out how he moved all of his guns unnoticed into a hotel room on the 32nd floor. From here, he waited until the concert ground was full of thousands of people. And then he started firing.
What we know is Stephen Paddock is a man who spent decades acquiring weapons and ammo and living a secret life, much of which will never be fully understood.
Stephen Paddock's girlfriend, Mary Lou Danley, has been questioned by the FBI. She flew back from her family home in the Philippines after hearing about the shooting. She said the 64-year-old paid for her to go, and she thought he was breaking up with her.
He wired me money, which he said was for me to buy a house for me and my family. I was grateful, but honestly, I was worried that first, the unexpected trip home, and then the money, was a way of breaking up with me.
Her sisters in Australia said she knew nothing about Stephen Paddock's plans.
I know that she don't know anything as well. Like, she was sent away. She was sent away so that she will be not there to interfere about his money.
America is once again grieving the victims of another mass shooting.
It's not fair and it's not right. And I'll forever have to have a bullet in my back. For no reason. So I'm just sorry other people have to deal with similar or worse injuries or losses.
Detectives say they still don't know why Stephen Paddock decided to commit mass murder, but they are building a picture of the killer, and they believe he had been planning this attack for some time. Laura Bicker, BBC News, Las Vegas.
Let's go to our North America correspondent, Rogini Vaidyanathan, who's also in Las Vegas for us. And Rogini, the police now saying they think that the gunman had been planning this potentially for months.
Yes, that's their theory, but they still do not have a motive there. Now, the FBI says usually in these kind of cases, they're looking for affiliation, motive, and intent. But the FBI concedes themselves that they are astonished that investigators have still been unable to uncover more information about the gunman. Now, one of the issues they say is that he had a very low-key private life. Very little can be found about him on social media. He had very few close friends, apart from, of course, from his girlfriend Mary Lou Danley, who is said to be cooperating with investigators. There are more than 100 investigators working on this case. Now, one area that they are looking at is the fact that the gunman checked in to a hotel, a different hotel, about a week before he carried out the attack at this particular hotel. And he had a room overlooking another music festival, the Life is Beautiful Festival in Las Vegas on around the September the 22nd. And his room there overlooked the vantage point of the music festival. So they are wondering whether or not he booked in there to perhaps plan to attack that. They also are looking at a purchase he made in October of last year, of more than 30 guns, and they are trying to work out whether he bought those in a response to what they describe as a specific life event. So there are the leads that they are looking at. And I have to say, several days on from the shooting here, they are still no closer to revealing what his motive might have been.
Regini, many thanks for being with us.
Thank you. Thank you.